Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa
barakatuh.
وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله بعثه الله رحمة للعالمين بشيرا ونذيرا فصلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, dear respected brothers, I'm going to speak today about something that is maybe a little bit different. I'm going to speak about one of the pillars of Islam that is different from the other pillars. It constitutes a social activism, financial activism, ibadah, and a political representation. It constitutes so many things. This pillar, as you know, is al-hajj. Al-hajj. Because in a matter of a few days, inshallah, we will be starting al-hajj. My dear respected brothers and sisters, if there is any, subhanallah, if you look at Islam, anything in al-Islam is amazing. Anything in al-Islam is a miracle. The nature of the five pillars of al-Islam, that nature attracts anyone, any human being will be attracted to Islam. The first pillar of al-Islam is the shahadatayn, to declare that you are Muslim. Okay, the first pillar after that, which is salah. Salah is five daily activities. It will attract many people because it is a physical, spiritual, intellectual activity that is taking place in the same time. Physically, spiritually, and mentally, you are working in the same time. That's why As-salah was frequently mentioned in the Quran. And Allah Jalla wa'ala said about As-salah that it is the main pillar that stops people from fahsha and munkar. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. And Allah Jalla wa'ala did not allow even people in the state of war to abandon salah. وَإِذَا كُنْتَ فِيهِمْ فَأَقَمْتَ لَهُمُ الصَّلَاةَ فَلْتَقُمْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ مَعَكَ وَلْيَأْخُذُوا حِذْرَهُمْ وَأَسْلِحَتَهُمْ فَإِذَا سَجَدُوا فَلْيَكُونُوا مِن وَرَائِكُمْ. Until the end of the ayah, Allah Jalla wa'ala said, if you were with them and you are meeting the enemies, yes, be careful, be ready for the salah. Take your weapons with you and you should split into two parts. One part will be ready to defend you and the other part will establish the salah. This is one in the state of war when you are meeting the enemies, subhanallah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the criteria between us and them, means the disbelievers, is salah. So this is Salah. We can talk a lot about Salah. Then after Salah, maybe someone maybe say Salah, 5 daily activities, it doesn't attract me that much to Islam. Then Zakah comes. Zakah comes. What is Zakah? Yes? Allah Jalla wa'ala said, if you have surplus, you have a social financial responsibility towards others. You cannot just live comfortably and other are dying because they don't find their basic necessities. You have to give them part of your money. Yeah? The Prophet ﷺ said, فَإِنْهُمْ أَطَاعُوكَ لِذَلِكَ فَأَعْلِمْهُمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ افْتَرَضَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُؤْخَذُ مِنْ أَغْنِيَائِهِمْ وَتُرَدُّ إِلَى فُقَرَائِهِمْ. When the Prophet ﷺ was addressing Mu'adh, he said, if they accept Islam, tell them about Salah. If they accept Salah, they start praying, tell them that Allah commanded them that they have to give an amount of their money for their poor people, which is a social responsibility. And it shows that you have to care for others. This is one of the pillars of Islam. Subhanallah, who will not be attracted to this? Who will not be attracted? Well, many people will be attracted to Islam. So Islam is bringing more people. Then we have Sawm. What is Sawm? Sawm, you do nothing. Sawm, you do nothing. Yeah, you just do nothing. You continue your work, your life as normal. But the key thing, in a month's time, don't eat and drink. Even that is better for your health. Don't eat and drink and involve yourself in sexual activities. That's it. Continue your normal life. Maybe in the first 3 days, you know, you become tired. But after that, it will become normal. As we have witnessed Sawm in the last few days. We had the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah, it attracts more people to Islam. Wallahi, brothers, you know, this year and last year and the year before, I started to interview people, yeah, who fasted. So how was fasting? Was so difficult. No. In the first few days was difficult, but then after that, we got used to it, it's all right. Some people never fasted. Some people don't pray. We always receive this question, Sheikh. Okay, what is the ruling of a person who doesn't pray, but he fasts? Is his fasting accepting or not? Why? Because the nature of fasting, it attracts different type of people. So they come to Islam, subhanAllah. And that's why after Ramadan, many people turn to Islam. See the power of Islam. Then we have Hajj. Hajj, if you look at it from... Maybe if you want to think about Hajj, what is it? Ibadah? Yes, definitely it is Ibadah. But it has more than that. Yeah? What is Ibadah? Is, if I use the word, having fun. Because you are traveling to another country. Traveling is what? People go travel for to another other countries for tourism. To enjoy their life. Yes. It is part of it. So a person who was not attracted to Islam by Salah, by Zakah, by fasting, he will look at this and he will be so amazed. He will come to Islam because of Hajj. He has to travel to another country. Not only that, he has to change his clothes, wear different clothes. Even this, rich people pay a lot of money in order to have a change in their life. Because if they are living in a very comfortable situation for a long time, they become sick. And yeah, I always remember a friend of mine, he went for a long training, and it was hosted by the customers. So they treat them as kings. He said, we went to America and we were living in 7-star hotels for almost a few months. He said, by the end of the period, I felt sick. The food is the best food. Yeah, the accommodation is the best accommodation. They bring Mercedes cars to, okay, take us. I felt sick because of too much luxury. So he said, what did I do? I traveled to one of the poor countries just to gain my human nature again, because before it was artificial. This happens in Al-Hajj. For men, they change their clothes. Wear simple clothes. They have to live in a particular way, next to each other. Come out of your comfort zone. This is very attractive. And that's why when people go to Al-Hajj, in the beginning they might find it difficult. After they finish Al-Hajj, you ask them, would you like to come to Hajj again? Oh yeah, of course. But you just suffered in Al-Hajj. No, it was okay. Yeah? This is the power of Al-Islam, Allahu Akbar. Okay, Al-Hajj again, people from different parts of the world, yeah, they come to meet in one place. This is a demonstration. This is to show political power. Yes, this is part of it. Who said that Islam separates between ibadah and politics? All of it is ibadah. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have created jinn and in for one purpose, which is ibadah. Everything we do is ibadah. Everything we do is ibadah. Even political engagement is ibadah. Yes, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. Yeah, if you know, understand tawheed, that there is no partner beside Allah Jalla wa Ala to be worshipped, as Ibrahim alayhi salam said, my salah, my sacrifice, my life, my death, all of it is for Allah Jalla wa Ala. Subhanallah. So, Hajj is a political demonstration. Hajj, you spend money. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَن تَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. You spend money. If you want to have business in Hajj, yes, go ahead. What is it? It is everything. Subhanallah. It is a life, a changing journey, my dear respected brothers and sisters. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala made this journey that is done once in a matter of few days. Allah Jalla wa Ala made it as one of the pillars of Al-Islam. Well, for a few days and khalas, that pillar is done. Salah is done every day until you die. Zakah, you should do it every year. Fasting, you should do it every year. But Hajj, a few days, you do it, and alhamdulillah, the obligation has been lifted. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Hajj marra. Hajj is one time. Yes? فَمَا زَادَ فَهُوَ تَطَوَّى. Whenever you do more Hajj, this is surplus, it will wipe your sins out. Yes, Al-Hajj, not only just, see, once we say that it is a pillar of Al-Islam, pillar means what? Imagine a building has pillars. You remove one pillar, the building will what?
Collapse.
Will collapse. That's why, subhanallah, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu once was giving a statement, a declaration, when he was the khatib, when he was the leader of that ummah. He said, I was about to appoint people to send them to the corners of the world to see who could have gone to Hajj, yet he did not go. He had the means to go for Hajj, but he didn't go. Yeah? To appoint jizya on them. Jizya is the tax that is taken from non-Muslims who live under the protection of the Muslim Ummah. To appoint jizya on them? Wow. Are you treating them as non-Muslims? Umar ibn al-Khattab said, ma hum bi muslimin, ma hum bi muslimin, ma hum bi muslimin. Of course, he's not declaring kufr upon them, but he said, how come they have the means to go for Hajj? Yes, and yet they do not go. Yeah? Subhanallah. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah Jalla wa Ala called Hajj as what? As a debt. Yes? The entire mankind. The entire mankind. And Hajj is unique from this perspective. When Allah Jalla wa Ala spoke about Salah, Allah Jalla wa Ala said, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Salah was prescribed upon believers. When Allah Jalla Ala spoke about fasting, Allah Jalla Ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. Allah addressed believers. But when Allah Jalla Ala spoke about Hajj, Allah Jalla Ala addressed what? The entire mankind. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. When Allah Jalla Ala commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to call people to come for Hajj, he said, وَأَذِّنْ, not in the believers, make adhan, not for the believers, no, for mankind. وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا. Subhanallah. It's not any pillar of Al-Islam. One of the companions or one of the scholars from the second generation, when they bring a janazah in front of him, he would say, did this person, was he wealthy? Yes, he was wealthy. Did he perform Hajj or not? If he didn't perform Hajj, he wouldn't offer janazah prayer on him. Subhanallah. My dear brothers and sisters, it is a serious issue. It is a serious issue. Many people, yeah, they say, next year, I'll do it next year, yeah? But who confirmed that you will be living until next year? Wallahi, brothers and sisters, with the way now we see it in front of our eyes, yeah? People, yani, we heard yesterday about the terrorist attack that took place in Spain. Yeah, you could be one of those. Is that true or not? Unfortunately, those crazy people, they don't distinguish between Muslims and non-Muslims. You could be walking with the non-Muslims. Yalla, let us kill non-Muslims by mass. Okay? And maybe you could have been killed. A few days ago, two brothers, one of them visited us from Holland, from Denmark. He was going to his home. There are gangs fighting, okay? Every gang wants to confirm their authority over a place. He was just walking with his friend. One of the gangsters took a machine gun. He is in the intensive care. Just like this. Can you confirm that you will be living until next year? Yeah? We have seen how many of us heard of some people, they were fully healthy, and then all of a sudden they had cancer? Yes or no? Like this. SubhanAllah, cancer? Yes, like this. May Allah Jalla wa'ala give them shifa, and may Allah Jalla wa'ala give them all the ill people shifa. Ameen. So you can't confirm that you will be living until next year. Okay, who also confirms that by next year, you would say the year after, the year after. How many times I received the questions from old sisters? Yeah, 65, 70, 75. Yeah, Sheikh, I want to perform Hajj, I want to go by myself. Is it allowed or not? Do I have to have a mahram? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said a woman should not travel 3 days except to the mahram. Do I have to go? Some scholars said that you can travel as a group, okay, without a mahram. Can I go without a mahram? Sister, why you need to go without a mahram? Why didn't you, have you performed Hajj before? Oh no, Sheikh, I didn't. Why, sister? Why? How old are you? 65, Sheikh. The last one, she told me, 65. And I have some illnesses. I said, why didn't you go before that? You have 40 years to go for Hajj. Yeah, Sheikh, you know, every year, okay, next year, until it happens like this. SubhanAllah. And even when we go for Hajj, yeah, when we go for Hajj, the elderly people, Sheikh, yeah, I am very ill. I can't go and do stoning. It is a long distance. Can someone do it on my behalf? Yeah? Oh, Sheikh, I can't stay for the full period in Muzdalifah because I am ill. Can I go early? Sheikh, can you give me an excuse, okay, to do this and that? They don't perform it well. They don't get the maximum of it. Why? Because they are ill. Why didn't you do it when you were young? We were just delaying it, delaying it, delaying it. Subhanallah. My dear brothers and sisters, apart from all of this, Allah Jalla wa Ala, please listen. Please listen. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, okay, go for this journey. Spend a few days. Yeah? Do it properly. You will come back as a newborn person, have no sin whatsoever. Allah Jalla wa Ala has given you this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, brothers, you can squeeze, okay? Yeah, squeeze as much as you can so we can accommodate more people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Mabroor Hajj, if you do it properly, has no reward less than Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, yeah, said, the one who performs Hajj and he's not involved in fusuq and sinning and indulge in sexual activities, okay, in a particular period of time, and he did not involve himself in arguments or fights, he will what? Come back from Hajj as a newborn person. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when women came to him and he said, Ya Rasulullah, men go for Hajj, men go for jihad. We want to go for jihad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, go for Hajj. Your Hajj, your jihad is what? Is Hajj. Allahu Akbar. All of these. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in one beautiful hadith, look at this. He said, as for you, when you are traveling to go for Hajj, Allah Jalla wa Ala will remove from you a sin for each step you take towards Mecca to perform your Hajj. Allahu Akbar. How many, if we imagine that we walk towards Mecca, how many steps we will take towards Mecca? Allahu Akbar. Allah Jalla wa Ala will remove number of sins equal to the number of steps towards Mecca. Not only that, Allah Jalla wa Ala will give you a single hasana for each step you take towards Mecca. Wow, all of this. Not only that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you shave your head, yes, and the hair falls down, Allah Jalla wa Ala will give you a hasana for each piece of hair that falls down. Allahu Akbar. Not only that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when it is the day of Arafah, Allah Jalla wa Ala descends to the lowest heaven. And Allah Jalla wa Ala doesn't descend to the lowest heaven except at the third part of night. But because Arafah is an exceptional day, Allah Jalla wa Ala what? Descends to the lowest heaven in the day of Arafah. Not only that, he will say to his angels, these are my, he will be boasting over his slaves. These are my slaves. Where did they come from? They came from every single corner of the universe. What do they want? He's telling the Malaika, because he's proud of us, those who went for Hajj. Yes, what do they want? Did they want money? No. Did they want? No. They came to get my forgiveness. Because they came for my forgiveness, you should be witnesses that I have forgiven all their sins. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you have sins equal to the pebbles, the number of pebbles of a big sand, Allah Jalla wa Ala will wipe all these sins. If you have sins equal to the number of days of this life, we don't know how many, millions, billions days of this life, Allah Jalla wa Ala will wipe them over, will delete all of them. Allahu Akbar. This is Hajj. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, if I have the opportunity to go for Hajj, Yes? Remembering all these rewards. Wallahi, I will go every year. 5, 6, 7 days. Yalla, 7 days, I'll have a clean myself and come back. Wow. Yes, and I will enjoy it. It is traveling, etc. All what I need is, wallahi, yesterday, brothers. Wallahi, I swear by Allah, yesterday. Yes? A young brother, he said, Sheikh, I'm so excited. I met him yesterday. He said, I am so excited. I said, Ya Allah, I want to go for Hajj. I've been to Umrah before, but I said, Ya Allah, I want to go for Hajj. Yeah? I don't have the means. I have 1,000 something, okay, or around 2,000. And the package that I found, they told me, you can come with us, etc. We can process it quickly. Yes? It's 4,300 pounds. He said, out of nowhere, yes, I received 2,500 pounds. Out of nowhere. Yeah? And then, wallahi, that young boy, may Allah Jalla wa Ala reward him and make him among the righteous people. Yes? He gave me a lesson. He said, Sheikh, you remember the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in tasduqillah, yasduq. That hadith, yes? A person said, Ya Rasulallah, I wish to go and fight the enemies of Allah. And I wish to receive an arrow here. Yes? To die for the sake of Allah. And he left. The Prophet ﷺ said, if he was truthful, honest with Allah, Allah will be what? Truthful to him. Which means what? That what? Allah give him, Allah will give him what? What he wanted. He died with an arrow here. So when the Prophet ﷺ saw him, he said, in tasduqillah, yes. When you wish khair, and you are sincere about it, brothers and sisters, wallahi, wallahi, Allah will give it to you and more. Allah may be test you. Allah may test you for a short period of time. But if you are honest with Allah and you wanted Allah, Allah will come closer to you and Allah will give it to you. Allah does not deprive anyone who wants to come closer to him. Wallahi, we have hundreds of stories. Hundreds of stories. Yeah? Especially visiting his place. Visiting his holy place, the holiest place. I remember, just it came to my mind. A person was working in Saudi Arabia. At that time, they had a system that you cannot travel without the permission of your sponsor. So his sponsor deported him. He said, please, let me go to have Umrah before you deport me completely from Saudi Arabia. His sponsor said, no. He said, just go for Umrah. I want to visit the house of Allah. He said, no. Immediately, from Dammam, another city, to that country. Yeah? So the guy, he felt so sorry. He wanted to visit the house of Allah before being deported from Saudi Arabia. Wallahi, what happened is a miracle. The plane had a technical problem. So the plane had to land to Jeddah, which is the next city to Mecca. And they said, you have a few hours before departing again. He went, performed Umrah, came back, took the plane, went. Look at this miracle. Allah is there, brothers and sisters. Allah is with us. Allah is more gentle to us than our own mothers. Allah is more gentle to us, more merciful to us, wallahi, than our own mothers and fathers. All what Allah Jalla wa Ala is asking us, come to me. Just come to me. Wish me. Be honest to me and you will see what I will give you. And Hajj is a great lesson for us to have and to implement this in our life. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله بعثه الله رحمة للعالمين بشيرا ونذيرا، فصلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، dear respected brothers, wallahi we want to talk a lot about Hajj and especially about this visiting the house of Allah. When we talk about Hajj, we cannot resist but to talk about the story of Ibrahim عليه السلام and his wife Hajar when they left by the command of Allah جل وعلا. And he left Hajar, his wife, and Ismail, his son. He was infant at that time. He left them well in the desert. Then he was commanded to leave. Hajar, his wife, said to him, Ibrahim, what are you doing? He said, I'm leaving. He said, leaving, and you are leaving us like this in this desert? No food, nobody, no water, water, no water. He said, Allah commanded me to do so. Look at this iman and belief. She said, if Allah commanded you to do so, Allah will not let us down. We remember this. And because of her, Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded the angel Jibreel to what? To hit the ground, and the spring of Zamzam came because of her and her son. Allahu Akbar. وَأَذْهِمْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ مُؤَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. This is Hajj, my dear brothers and sisters. Still you have time. Those who did not go for Hajj, you have time. Please find out and go. Enroll yourself and go. If you could not go this year, please make sure you go next year. Make sure you go next year. Make sure, my dear brothers and sisters, that whenever you can go for Hajj, go. You will never regret it. In fact, wallahi, you will regret that you did not go. And subhanAllah, quickly, brothers and sisters, out of rahmah of Allah Jalla Ala, out of Allah's mercy, that those who did not or who could not go for Hajj, Allah Jalla Ala told them, I gave you the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Yes, they are the best of the days. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, there are no days in which the good deeds are more beloved to Allah Jalla Ala than the first 10 days of the Hijjah. So increase tahleel, takbir, tahmeed. Increase good deeds in those 10 days. Those 10 days, brothers, they will start inshallah next Wednesday. Next Wednesday. Yeah? For 10 days. Get the maximum of them. Every second worth millions is a treasure. Don't keep your tongue, yes, and mouth closed. Just make dhikr of Allah Jalla Ala. Make dhikr of Allah. Fast in those days. Do the sacrifice, the udhiyah. Prepare yourself to do the maximum in those 10 days. Give sadaqah. And remember also to fast the day of Arafah. The Prophet ﷺ said, fasting the day of Arafah, yes, will wipe the sins of 2 years. Some scholars said, fasting the day of Arafah is like fasting 10,000 days. Don't miss that. Don't miss that. Yes? One of the scholars said, wake up your children. Let them have sahur, not to miss the virtues of the day of Arafah. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us among those who witness those days. And we ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to give us the ability to go for Hajj. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to forgive our sins and to pardon our shortcomings. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to give us the strength to worship Him and to please Him as He should be pleased. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i wal amwat wal muslimina wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Ya hayyu ya qayyum bi rahmatika nastaghith. Ya hayyu ya qayyum bi rahmatika.
أستغيب وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يا رب.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
الحديث بخاشعة وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم